stenosis. This delirium comes with stenosis. It's quite late now. Oh, and now the FPS counter activates. It's weird that sometimes it doesn't activate and stuff that, like, I don't know what that's about, you know, but yeah. Restoring sanity here. And then you need to recover dragon bones, and then you finally get like a quest to go up there and slay the dragon thing. Actually, let me do that while we're here, because I don't know if they will show you all the items anymore. I don't think they do. Before, they used to show you all the items you could get from a quest, which I hated when they moved, because, you know, I also wish that it would be easier, because they made it so that you have to do lore master on several characters if you want to get all the transmog gear. And he wants you to kill Bloodcursed Naga and stuff. Well, I believe these had rewards, dude. I don't know why they don't show up rewards for those quests, you know. That's weird to me, but yeah, you need to collect dragon bones pretty much. But it's from over here and stuff. And at least there are a question of killing that thing up there. But of course, rewards that I can say thing, but if you're on a priest, for example, it rewards you with a very, very nice thing. And then of course you need those mushrooms. They say that for one of the mushroom quests with that other thing. Well, yeah, I'm doing some mythics there that I want to do. Mind shift. Only thing I hated is that there were certain achievements that I had almost gotten before achievement became like account-wide, and a lot of the things, you know, before a lot of the achievements that became account-wide, there were like certain things that I did on my old account and stuff there, like back during like the cataclysm thing, you know. I had done like the fishing thing of fishing up the thing in Orgrimmar and Iron Forge and stuff that I had done that, you know. And stuff that, you know, so yeah. That's what's going on with that, you know. One thing, you know, of course, that on the videos that I uploaded yesterday, for some reason I did talk about Final Fantasy 15. They know the thing. There we go. Yeah. Alright, we can do this. Because that actually seems to save on frame rate for some reason. I don't know why, but it seems like certain things, you know, just saves your frames. Stuff that, you know, save the frames, save the world. Yeah. This quest could actually be quite annoying at times, but one thing which is interesting is certain quest items counts as certain things. Like, for example, if you get herbalism, there's a quest to do, for example, to find a shore dragon thing something, and those you can find easily when you have the herbalism thing, and you can find mushrooms easy with herbalism as well, which is something to remember. It's weird what mobs dropped the Telabim Banana, you know. It wouldn't make sense if they would have dropped from apes and stuff, you know, but yeah, you know. Wait, it's a level 5 food now? That's odd. That used to be way higher, if I remember correctly. That used to be way high, but yeah. I just want to show you here the chain, like hopefully I can see what the other rewards are. I think I will though be able to see what the other rewards are. Because of the fact that these are still TBC zones, so they still didn't have the new system in them, you know. So yeah. I wish that the lore master for this area, or for the TBC areas, then will become like a feat of strength or something like that, if you have done them, you know, and stuff that if they ever change the sorting zones here and stuff. But yeah. Is it the mushrooms after this, or was it killing the whelps that was after? I forgot. Into the dream, yeah. Yeah, you need to slay the whelps now. And I always used to think that these should have dropped a pet. But there's a pet that looks similar to them, I believe. That drops in wetlands, the whelps you can kill, that drops something, I believe. Because there are certain whelp pets that have a little drop rate that's actually worth a ton on the auction house. Stuff that. So yes. And these quests back in the day were actually not that easy because these used to be higher level mobs and they used to have more health and then they could cast sleep on you and stuff that, and then they would throw fireballs which would do a lot of damage. The whelps are more rare. But yeah, there were some pretty cool things though, and they should now be the either mushrooms or the other thing, but I think the mushroom were part of the mushroom chain, or it was from the Draenei over here at the Windicator's Rest. It might have been from that. Into the Rainboom Razor Maw, yeah. Do you get the breastplate of the Dragon Slayer from that? But the thing is, back in the day, when I don't have the rep buff anymore, lol. Which is bad. So far. It goes way quicker if you do it in a group though, but I used to have the Blood Sail title back in Cataclysm actually on one of the characters, you know. Oh, a thin one. On certain servers, I remember back in Vanilla and TBC, certain things become worth a lot. Like, I remember being able to twink out a lower level character, even though I didn't have a max level one. You know, that should attract the dragon. There he is. He used to be an elite, actually, and he used to be rather tough back in the day. Raise him off. I think I despawned him or something, no, there it comes. Might be that I wasn't calling him down before. Then he starts attacking. I'm just gonna show you here a bit what he does here. He has Flame Breath, which would do a lot of damage. It applied a dot, I believe. And he has a fear thing also, I think. Yeah, there we go, there's the fear. To find more. And yeah, then you see what the problem would be when you would fight him at a lower level, then you would lucky run into the dragons, and the dragons would hit you really, really hard, and this used to be a group quest with three people, I believe. So yeah, it was really quite insane, to be honest, you know. Like, that guy used to be an elite, and then the whelps weren't elite, I don't think, but they were like really, really tough, like they have way more health than this, you know, and they would like poison bolt you, as you see, poison bolt, which is what the broodlings would do, and then they would also sleep you. I'm gonna see if they're gonna do it. It might have been the whelps that sleeps you. Or have they removed the sleep from them? I think they have removed the sleep. Come on, one more. Okay, not. It might be the whelps then. There's a whelp. I think whelps has fireball. Hello, Mr. Whelp. Fireball me, please. pretty certain they have spells. Where's that toy? What is that? Foam sword. I thought I had it favorite for some reason. Symbol looks like. Yeah, there we go. Can I do more damage? Oh yeah. I can actually kill it with that. That was the first time I used it. It looked pretty hilarious. You like bonked it on the head. Be a transformable item. Yeah, and that gave me a lot of rep. I got breastplate of the dragon's slayer. And of course the thing is on cloth users. There's a super sexy robe you can get from that of Dragon Slayer's robe, which looks amazing to be honest. I thought they would show me what the other rewards are, because I remember on the Paladin back in the day you were able to choose what reward you wanted. And I remember almost wanting the obvious because it looked so good, you know, to be honest. Okay, let's go find that stupid gnome now. I mean, I think I've shown it in another video where I've been in these areas, you know, because of what the parts are always. Nice to loot, because sometimes it contains like really good engineering items, and certain engineering items are worth a lot on the auction house if there are people trying to raise engineering. Of course some people just wait, picking professions until max level, but I find that to be boring, you know, when it's more fun to actually level your professions like naturally instead of just waiting till you're like max level and then just doing stuff, you know. But yeah, this is where he is, the gnome. Which can give you that, and this, which gives you the treasure map, which is what gives you the thing. Robles card, coarse bears and powder. Sometimes it can give you other stuff as well. And this of course where the bear is for the beast. For the buckler thing. He's here, Deathclaw. But he has a pretty cool model. And you can tame him. You can see he's not necessarily affected, he's just damaged, he's war-torn pretty much. A war-torn bear. And he loves delicious bear meat, you know. And of course the Royal Blue Flutters, I believe, does give you a quest item, or is it no? It's not a quest item, it's actually from another thing. It's from the Vindicator Rest area, pretty much. Yeah. And where's the Nectar?